can stop us. Nothing can hold us down. Death is defeated. Jesus, you have overcome. Hey! Come on, sing it.
Nothing can stop us. Nothing can hold us down. Death is defeated.
Shout it out,
shout it out, he is risen. Our God is alive in us.
Shout it out,
shout it out.
you just go ahead and give him praise? Put your hands together and just thank the Lord. Yes, he is wonderful.
Praise the Lord. How many were here last night? Raise your hand. Wow. You didn't get enough, did you? How many of you would have just stayed a little bit longer? That's what I thought. I would have too. How many were not here last night? Raise your hand. Oh, wow. Praise the Lord. Well, we're going to change the flow up a little bit this evening. You guys may go ahead and be seated for a moment. It doesn't mean that worship's over, but we're just going to change things up a little bit, and we're going to focus on the offering a little bit right now this evening at the beginning of the service. And I'm going to invite Brother Andre up, and I want you to get ready to give your best gift tonight, and then we're just going to see how the Holy Ghost leads us. But we're very honored and privileged to have a man of God with us. I'll be honest with you, he truly is a man of God. I've spent time with him. It's about the kingdom of God. He has such an anointing on him that brings leaders together. The anointing is there in such a way to bring leaders together to where they'll lay down their denominational walls and just advance the kingdom. And that's the anointing that rests upon this. It's part of the anointing that rests upon this man. So if you would, at this moment, please just give a hand and welcome Brother Andre. As he comes, he's going to tell you a little bit more about the ministry and about the ministry going on around the world.
Come on, let's give God good praise. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you. Praise the Lord. This is a moment that we would like to receive an offering that will come into the ministry called Good News to the Nations. The word good news in Greek is euangelion, good tidings. That's what it's all about. Jesus is good news. And church, the reason I would like to prepare you for this offering is not because we try to get something into our pockets, because nothing of what you give comes to me personally. It comes to the ministry, and the ministry has a board of directors that makes decisions, and I just submit to that. And I just returned from South Africa about 2 weeks ago, and we have a great ministry going on in South Africa. The needs is overwhelming. I have a missionary that's working in Mozambique, and just over the border in a place called Pafuri. That's about 400 miles from anything that looks like civilization. In the 80s, there was a great terrorist war going on there. Well, he's doing a phenomenal job there. We have delivered two steel structures. We have somebody that just donated the walls to be built. He channeled water to the local people. He was in a breakfast that I presented in Johannesburg about 3 weeks ago. And on the spirit of the moment, I took up an offering for him. And I found out he lives in a little, a motorhome, trailer, but a small trailer. And in that area, Pafuri gets about 125, 130 Fahrenheit degrees in the summertime. When you look at all his whole circumstances, you ask the question, why will a man do such a thing? But that's what the calling does to you. It's not, when you call by the Lord, you do strange things. And so, church, this is just one little man, just one story. And I'm going to bless him in December. He doesn't know it. I already blessed him, and I'm going to bless him more. When I found out where he lives and what his wife is exposed to, I decided it's my responsibility, because I know. Somebody that doesn't know doesn't need to do anything, but I know. And the moment you have knowledge about something, you have a responsibility. And he this Christmas, he's going to be super blessed. He just doesn't know it yet. So that's just one little nugget from Africa. We want to plant more churches. We want to do more crusades. I have a team there that does outreaches amongst the very poor. I would like to buy them a new truck. I would like to, because they need it. I want to buy them a better platform. I want to buy them better lights. In February this year, they did a crusade and in a place called Boomplas, where most of the black people there, well, actually the black people there has never seen a white person. They saw them the first time. Couldn't believe there's such a thing like a white person. And they were in the hills of Boomplas, and there was a lot of tombstones in the hills. Thousands of tombstones, and there's a lot of ancestral worship. And one night when they started with a crusade, they put on the lights. And as far as the lights could shine, the people would come and walk for a day to come to the crusade. And the moment they step into the light, hundreds of people start to fall out under the power of God, and they start to crawl like snakes. It's demonic. And the team saw it, and they just said, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And demons start to fly out and come out left, right, and center. These are the people that needs it. They need the gospel. And at the moment, we are planning to deliver a steel structure there. I already have the steel structure in South Africa. It's already prepared. We're going to take it up there. It's going to be a long journey. And we're going to plant a church there. And so this is just a little glimpse into Africa. You know, when you come to a meeting like this, you say tonight, I would like to have a prophetic word. I would like to God to heal me. And when we get to that part of the service, things is going to happen. The Holy Spirit is already here. But you know what? Before we have a miracle here, that's for you. We need to have a miracle now in the offering for others. And church, I want to be honest with you that for about a month, we had no offerings, no income. And I love moments like this, because when you are down and out, then the Lord comes in and normally does a miracle. So when you give tonight, this is part of what you give into. The upper room, you remember 3 weeks from now, we have an upper room here. And I just sent out a letter this afternoon to leaders to update them on who's coming. We have a lot of leaders coming in. And God needs to untie my hands to do more upper rooms in America and stir the states and different regions to bring back the fire of prayer. And so, church, I believe tonight and tomorrow night, I have no idea what came in yesterday. I don't ask. I don't run by numbers. I'm not somebody that go to any church and say, I want so much per service. I know these people that do that. I want to stay in such and such a hotel. I don't do that. So I don't know what came in yesterday. All I know is by tomorrow night, I will have a miracle in my hand. I know it. I know it. I don't know you, but I know him. And while I do have a good idea who Maranatha is, but I know him better. And when you give tonight, will you just be that person that can help us to make a miracle happen? May the Lord bless you, and thank you.
Let's get your best gift out. You're getting ready to sow in some very fertile soil this evening. And we've been hearing testimonies for the past couple of weeks about what happens when you begin to sow. Remember, we shared those testimonies with you yesterday. I don't believe I shared it the second one. I don't think I shared it last night about the gasoline, did I? I shared it yesterday morning at 9, but last week, there was a lady, if you've heard this before, just act like you've never heard it and celebrate it, okay? But there was a lady that was going to call off work. She was going to call off work last week. I believe it was last Friday. She was going to call off work when she went in on Thursday because she didn't have enough money to put gas in her car to make it to work. So she was just going to take off Friday. And she said, but Thursday afternoon before she left, her boss came in and handed her an envelope. And in that envelope was a bonus check. And it said, just for your extra effort, thank you. And that bonus check was enough to put gas in her car and buy her groceries for this upcoming week. And she had stated in there, she said, Sunday morning, she said, I put my tithe and my offering in the tithe and offering. She said, I put it in there and was just believing God to see me through. I'm telling you, God does amazing things. And I know this man of God. We have supported this ministry through Christ's birthday offering for several years. We've really vamped up the support the past few years because we just believe in it so great. There's many men and women of God that are just that we pour into. But I assure you that this one, you have a firsthand opportunity to sow into this ministry tonight, and I just ask you to be obedient to the Holy Spirit. Father, we just come to you. We thank you for who you are. Father, before you do anything else tonight, we just want to say thank you, Father. We want to thank you for the miracle that's coming around the corner. We want to thank you for your provision. We want to thank you for an opportunity to give tonight, God. It's always a privilege to give. It's better to give than to receive. So tonight, you've placed us in a good position where we can give, and it's better to give. So, Father, we pray that you would just do what you desire to do. We pray that you would move in the way that you desire to move. And, Father, may you be glorified in the midst of all of it. And we ask it in Jesus' name. And amen.
those hands. Come on, do something right now in honoring the Savior, the Redeemer, the risen King. Oh, the risen King, the matchless one of glory. Oh, we honor you, Lord, we honor you, yes. Oh, we honor you, yes, oh King, oh King, King of kings, Lord of lords, majesty. Oh, we honor you, we welcome you to come in, we welcome you to come in. Our hearts burn for you, oh.
Let's just worship the Lord. I want them to sing a song that I really love. It's called Spirit of the Living God. Is that what it is? You've sang it a few times this week. Sometimes you need to learn there's always a song in the midst of them all that God kisses. Every song has the kiss of God on it, but sometimes one of the songs has a sloppy kiss. This one. I want them to sing this one, and there's a certain portion of the song where the song says, when you fall, I fall. That's where it really gets sloppy. Now watch what I said. So let's do this song and let's worship Him. Amen? Thank you.
Yeah.
worship Him. Everybody lift your hands and everybody worship. Not clapping, worship. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Let Him hear your voice. You are a worshiper. Before you are an accountant, and before you are a businessman, and before you are a prophet or an evangelist, you are a worshiper. God made you to worship. The rocks cannot worship. The animals cannot worship. The trees cannot worship. You are the only part of creation that can worship. Because you are the only part of creation that has His Spirit. Lift your voices. Come on. Come on. We welcome you, Lord Jesus. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. We welcome you, the one who resurrected Him out of the tomb. We welcome you back in America, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, you are not in the Constitution. You are amongst us. You're not in the back room. You're in the main room. Come on. Lord, we are not here for the boardroom. We are here for the upper room. We are not in a classroom. We are in the upper room. Come on, just worship Him. Maybe you are tired, and maybe you are weary, and maybe you are worn out. And maybe you say, I cannot stand on my feet. Well, sit down, but just open your mouth and just speak another word. Just worship Him. Father, we thank you tonight for what you're going to do. Because when you do what you do, oh my God, oh my Lord, when you do what you do, then we are happy, we're satisfied, we are overwhelmed. Father, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Come on, church, just worship Him. One more time, just worship Him, just worship Him. Pelemano la braca seca, lamento la monto la bata, lamento la baca la bato, lamento la ba seca la banto. Come on, nobody said the worship should be 10 songs. This is part of the worship. The Holy Ghost already knew in the beginning they will sing what they can sing, and then we will do what we can do. This is part of the worship. Hallelujah. This is just as important as the praise team. When the crowd say, give us a chance. When the crowd say, can we sing a song? I want you to start to sing a song right where you are, because you say to heaven, it's my turn now. I want to sing a song. Come on, church. The day when they put up a tombstone for me, I would like to sing all the songs I would like to sing before they do that. Come on, so sing Him a song and just worship Him. Father, we thank you for a good night. We thank you for an awesome night in the presence of the Lord. Appalamento, lamento, lamento, la monte, la bresse, la mano, la brera, la monte. Pelamento, la breche seca, la manto, la manto, la mando, la brera, la monte, la breche seca, la mano, la ventoia, la ventoia. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You can give me that. Woo! Come in, Lord, come in. Welcome. Welcome, Holy Ghost, welcome. Come on, church, the Lord is here like a flood. Come on, church, there's water coming into the building. There's water coming into the building. Come on, church, there's water. A flood coming into the building. Whoa! Why don't you allow your feet and your ankle bones to be healed? Why don't you allow the healing power of Jesus to flow up from your feet, up into your bones, into your kneecaps, into your... And come on, church, He's here. Oh, Lord, I thank you. Let your fire fall upon this place, and let your Holy Ghost baptize them, and let healing occur from the left to the right, the front to the back, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Oramana la brella manto la manto la brella monta la bressa la monta la bala manta la mondoia. Nema la monte la bressa la manto la bante la banto la mento la mosse la banto la mantoia. Purra batterra mante la barra. Irret la monte la mante la bressa bala monte la mento. You are the healer. You are the resurrection and the life. You are the miracle working Jesus. Lord, where you are, you leave nobody sick. Where you are, you leave nobody untouched. Come on, is he welcome here tonight? Can he just be him? Will you allow him to just be Jesus of the New Testament? Not the Baptist Jesus, not the Assemblies of God Jesus, not the Maranatha Jesus, not the Presbyterian Jesus, not the Church of God Jesus. Now the Roman Catholic Jesus, welcome to the New Testament Jesus, the Jesus with no wrappings, the Jesus with no religious spirit upon him. Come on, let him take over and let him be wild amongst us. Lord, I want you to throw fire on your people and let your people just be baptized with who you are in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Somebody do a little bit of celebration, you and the Holy Ghost. Just you and the Holy Ghost. Forget about the neighbor. Forget about your friend, your husband, your wife. Come on, you and the Holy Ghost. Do a one-on-one celebration. Take the hands of the Holy Ghost and do a dance with him. The Holy Ghost. There's somebody that had a problem here in your neck. It could be a goiter. A goiter. You know what that is? Test it. God has healed you. Who is that? Somebody, God is messing with your throat down here. What happened, ma'am? Well, keep your hand there. She said half of it's gone. You think Jesus is a half Jesus? He's complete. Oh, while you keep your hand there, the rest will go too. There's somebody else that has the same, a similar problem. Who is that? Come now. I want to see who that is. I know you are here. God showed me that twice. Twice. Come here, ma'am. Come up the platform. Amen. Bring her. Bring her. Bring her. Bring her. I saw it in the beginning, and I steered away from it, and I came back, and the Lord said, what happened here? She was diagnosed with a goiter.
Yeah, she's diagnosed with a goiter. She's a
worship leader. And now, where is it? Come on, try to find it. It's gone. I told you, he's real. Come on, church. Test your breast. Test your body for limbs. Hallelujah. Rapatelemendo praseca levento. What's going on here? Come here, come here, come here. Could you feel it? You're overwhelmed. Yeah. How do you know it's gone? What happened there? Did you feel something? Say that again.
I haven't had a voice, and I'm just speaking perfectly clear.
And you're a worship leader?
Yes, yes, sir.
Would you like to sing a song? Just sing us one line, or help her, whatever. Just sing us one line. Sing us one line now.
Don't even... Hallelujah.
Do it again. Lord, give God praise. Just lift your hands and worship Him. There's somebody that had an ear problem and God is working on your ear. You can feel it. It's almost like there's a finger, an unseen finger busy with your ear. Check it out. God is healing your ear. Who is that? Come on. Right now in Jesus' name. Lord, we give you full reign. Let your name be lifted up above this place. Amen. You had an ear problem? What happened? Check her out for me. Don't check her out. Somebody check her out. Find out what's going on there. Where's Chris? Find out what's going on there. Hallelujah. Lebalamonte le meno la vasseca le mento la manto la manto la brosse le mento. Hela la la manto. There's another person with something with the ear. And it doesn't mean you are deaf. It could be some other problem, but the finger of God is working there. And if you feel the sensation of the Holy Spirit, could be a hot feeling, a hot sensation. Most of the time when the Lord healed people, they feel the fire of God in the ear or in the chest or in the right where they need the healing. And it could happen right now. Father, we thank you for a miracle in Jesus' name. Oh, she's deaf. Lord, we pray that that deaf spirit will go in Jesus' name. Ha, pa, pa, tu, ha. Deaf spirit, come on, in the name of Jesus, leave and let her ears pop open in Jesus' name. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Happa la mono la vaca seca lamento la monte lamento la manta. Wow. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Just keep on worshiping Him. This is what we came for. Come on, we did not come for three fast songs and two slow ones, an offering and a sermon. Is that what you call church? Church is when Jesus shows up and He starts to heal people. Bella monta la meseca la manto la monta la brisela mano la bate la mandoia. Just worship Him one more time. Father, we give you praise. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your anointing. We thank you for your kindness. There's another person with a problem with a throat. I don't know what it is, but there's another one. And God says God's going to heal you in the name of Jesus. Who are you? If you are that person that also want to come out and just tell us what's happening here, amen. Who is that person? Just lift your hand and just come now. Come, ma'am. I want to hear what's going on there. In Jesus' name. Oh, quickly. What happened? What's going on? Huh? You have? Put your hands there. Lord, I thank you. She's laying her own hands on her. And I thank you, Lord. You're going to touch her right now in Jesus' name. We give you praise. You may be seated just for a moment. Amen. You guys can just stay here if you can stand on your feet the whole night. You're willing to do that for Jesus? Not for me, for Jesus. Amen. I just want to read something to you in 2 Kings chapter 4. Maybe you should be seated. Yeah, you can sit right there. I just want to read you a scripture. It's very familiar. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 9. This is a Shunammite woman, and she was a wealthy woman, and she said in verse 9, I just feel like I need to say this to you because some of you could wonder what's going on here. I want to show you what's going on here. It says in verse 9, and she said to her husband, look now, look now, look. Come on, look and see. Open your eyes. Most people, they see, but they never observe. They see, but they never perceive. They see, but they never discern. But she said, look now. And then she said something else. She says, I know. It's almost like she takes the moment and she seizes the moment. Everybody say, seize the moment. She said, look now, I know. Those are strong words. That sounds like somebody who has something to say. Come on. That sounds like, it's almost like she brings everything to a standstill. And she's saying to her husband, look now, I know. When somebody starts like that, you need to know something just happened. She says, look now, I know this is. Not this could be, this might be. Most probably, she said, this is. Can you see how firm is her words? She says, this is a holy man of God who passes by us regularly. That's her statement. She made an observation. Do you record this? I hope so. She made an observation. I did not plan to talk about this. She made an observation and she said, look now, I know this is a holy man of God who passes by us regularly. That's her observation. Now watch what the next verse says. She said to her husband, she says, please, please. That's a very kind way of asking him. She said, please, let us. Now she brings the whole emphasis back to themselves. She says, let us make a small upper room on the wall and let us put a bed for him there and a table, a chair, a lampstand, so that whenever he comes to us, he can turn in. Now what happened here is, she saw the prophet Elisha. And she saw him pass by the house regularly. And when she saw him the next time, she said to her husband, I know this is a holy man of God passing by. Church, it's about time that America seizes the moment. This moment that God comes, and most of the time, most people never observe it. Maranatha, I beg you, don't miss what's happening here. Don't let the moment pass by and you never realize what it was. Most people miss the kairos moment of God's visitation. She said, I know this is a holy man. You see, church, when you see the real anointing, you know it. When you see the fake, you will discuss it and you will doubt it. When you see the real anointing, you know it. She said, I know. And then she said, let us, it's almost like she's saying is, that's what it is. But us, we have a responsibility. Come on. She said, let us build a room for him. He never asked for the room. He never talked to her about a room. She said, I want to do something so that when he comes by again, he will not pass. But I cannot get him to turn in, and there's nothing to turn into. So she said to her, I'm not preaching, I'm just decreeing. So she said to her husband, let us build a room quickly and let us furnish the whole room so that when he passed by, he has a reason not to pass by. How many of you are willing to give him a reason not to pass by? Where I am, he will not pass by. Do you know that she actually went out and she grabbed a hold of him and she pulled him into the house? That's what you need to do with the Holy Ghost. You need to get aggressive and get a grip on him and say, no, 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 Jesus, you must come in here. I've got you a table, I've got you a chair, I've got you a lampstand, and I've got you a bed. Don't build him a room, furnish the room. Don't do something half-heartedly, do something complete. How many of you are here to build on and build on in a decent way? Now, she said, I want him to turn in. You see, church, a pass-by blessing and a turn-in blessing is two different blessings. You know, many people go to church just for a pass-by, in by 8, out by 9, in by 9, out by 10, in by 10, out by 11. That's pass-by blessings. I'm not into that. I want something that I can say he turned in and he turned up my house, my household. She said, I want him to turn in. And then watch what happened here. And the prophet Elisha said to Gehazi, call this Shunammite woman. Verse 11 said, it happened. What happened? It says, and it happened one day that he turned in. You say, well, I wish certain things want to happen in my life. Well, nothing will happen unless you make it happen. The Bible says, it happened one day that he passed by and he turned in. But it happened after she built on. So give God a reason for something to happen. Come on. Give him a reason for something to happen. And he turned in and watch this. Elisha was now on the bed. The bed speaks of rest. Don't give him a room with a chair and a lampstand, but you never give him a bed. Come on. If you give him a bed, you actually say, I want him to use the bed because that's the one item in the bed that'll make him stay longer. You never use a chair as long as you use a bed. And the Bible says when he was on the bed, he said to Gehazi, Gehazi was his servant that walked with him. And he said to Gehazi, call this Shunammite woman. Do you know that he never said call the husband? She spoke to the husband to get the money. That's why she had to build on. But when Elisha called a prophet, when he called the one, not the one who gave the money. He called the one who seized the moment, who saw the holiness. Come on. Amazing. God knows who's the one who initiate the building. God knows the motive of your heart. That's what he said, call the woman. And there's a lot of stuff here. I don't really want to preach this. But I'm just saying to you. And he said to him, say now to her, look, you have been concerned for us with all this care. What can I do for you? Now, church, not everybody can do something for you. But sure, somebody like Elisha can do something. How many of you know there are certain anointings that you would love that person to say, can I talk to you? Elisha said, what can I do for you? Now, you know what happened. Elisha said to her, and she basically said, no, there's nothing that you can do for me. I'm happy. You know why she said that? Because she said, I'm happy with what I have in my house. I have Elisha. Elisha is the type of the Holy Spirit. And Elisha said to her, can I introduce you to the king and to the commander of the army? And basically she said to him, I'm not interested in connections. I'm interested in presence. I mean, Elisha had two great friends, the king and the commander of the army. It's two of the top officials in the nation. And Elisha said, I give you an option. Would you like me to connect you with big names? And she says, no, I have the Holy Ghost in my house. Big names has nothing to... Come on, church. The problem with the modern day church is we run after big names when we have the Holy Ghost. I don't want to go deep here because we're going to stay the whole night. She said, who's interested in the king and who wants to know the commander of the army when you already have the prophet Elisha in the house? Come on, church. Who do we have in the house tonight? We have God in the house. We have the Holy Spirit in the house. And then something else happened here, and I will stop soon because I don't want to go too long with this. So he said, what can be done for her? And Gehazi said, actually, she has no son and her husband is old. Now, Gehazi was not the prophet. He was just a servant to the prophet. And he said, actually, she has no son and her husband is old. So now Elisha got an updated status of what her household looked like. How many of you realize that your status is well known to God? God knows what's going on in your household. God knows your husband is not here. God knows your wife is not here. God knows what your finances look like. Gehazi said, she has no son and her husband is old. Now why does he bring the husband into the whole picture? Because in order to have a son, you need a husband. That's pretty common sense. But you know what? When he said her husband is old, he actually said her seasons is gone. She missed all the seasons and she cannot have her seasons back. Your seasons is never gone when God is in the house. Come on. You cannot say that you've missed anything when God can restore it. He said, she has no son and her husband is old. That means the season for children is gone. Now, the word son, in the Old Testament, to have a son was to have honor. To have a son, the word son means ministry. And the word son means carrier of future generations. So Gehazi said to the prophet, she will never touch future generations. She has no honor. Now remember, she was a wealthy woman. She was a very wealthy woman. She had money, but no honor. She's a type of the church. She had a lot of money. Sounds like the American church. They have money, but they do not have honor. They have money, but they do not have ministry. They have money, but they do not touch the future generations. That's actually the prophetic picture of this woman. Gehazi said, before you prophesy, man of God, it doesn't look good. Because the old man is a wreck. And unless you prophesy, you better rethink. Because you And you know what, Elisha? Elisha did not say, let me have a committee meeting and call in my board of directors and see whether I can have a majority vote, whether I can prophesy such a thing. When God releases a word, your old body will line up with God's word. God's word is not going to line up with your body. Your body is going to line up with God's word. Your sickness is going to line up with God's word. Your diseases is going to line up with God's word. The curse upon your body is going to line up with God's word. God's word will not change so that, come on, church. It's not about you. It's about what you will become. Now watch this. So he said, call her. That's all he said. Call her. The moment he got information, he said, call her. Don't let God find out about you. You're in for a call. Bible says she stood in the doorway. Now, she climbed the steps back to the room that she built. Bible says she stood on the threshold. How many of you believe we are on a threshold? Come on. You are on a threshold. Bible says she stood on the threshold. She stood on a threshold that she built herself. She stood on a threshold that she financed herself. And when she looked at Elisha, she was exposed to a prophetic mantle, a prophetic anointing that's going to throw a word at her and that's going to revolutionize her whole life. Come on. You should build your own threshold for your miracle that you need. Hallelujah. If I don't get a word, I build my own threshold and I stand on it and I say, come on, Holy Ghost, talk to me. Bible says she stood on the threshold and Elisha said to her, next year this time, you will have a son. You will have honor. You will have glory. You will touch future generations. Come on, church. 4 months later, she was pregnant. She said to the old man, you will not believe me. It worked. Come on. Come on. You should have seen that old man. It's got nothing to do with you, old man. It's because somebody else discerned who walked by the house. Come on. If I can discern, I can benefit other people. If I can discern what's coming to America, then I can be influential that other people will say, my God. God restored her honor. Now, church, when Elisha said to her, you will have a son, you know what she said? She says, no man of God, don't lie to me. Lie. She uses the word lie. That's a strong word. Do you know, church, that God can surprise you to the point when it happens, you will think it's a lie. Now, let me say one more thing. When she saw Elisha, she never had pregnancy in mind. When she saw the holiness upon his life, she never thought that they will have a son. You see, the modern day church have a prescribed idea of what can happen in a service. You have no idea. When she became pregnant, that's why she said, don't lie to me. Because you see, if she really knew how holy he was and what the mantle was all about, she would not have said, don't lie to me. So although she discerned who Elisha was, she had no clue where this thing will end. When you come into a Holy Ghost environment, church, do you know, I am what I am today because I have been on the thresholds of a few moments in my life that then when I walked out of that service, I knew that my life has just been transformed forever. And I want to say to you tonight, you are on the threshold of a moment if you can only see it. Come on. Aren't you glad the old man gave the money? Because he must have given the money because they built a room. But you know what? He never knew that he's giving money so that God can restore his body to produce, come on. How many of you believe that God can restore things in your life so that you can go back into production? And I'm not talking about producing children. I'm talking about production in general. Come on. God wants you to be fruitful financially. God wants you to be fruitful in all spheres of life. You know what? I'm fruitful. André Francel is fruitful. I'm fruitful in many ways. Why am I fruitful? Because I'm better than you? No. I have just learned that when he comes into my life, every aspect of my life shows that God has touched me. Come on. My house will show it. My cars will show it. My trees will show it. Everything. And I want to say to you tonight, when you seize a moment of the Holy Ghost, the first thing God's going to do is he's going to restore all production in your life. How many of you believe God for a better financial year, a better health year, whatever, your children, anything that you touches must show that you seized a moment and now you carry the fruit of what you saw pass by. If you say tonight, I seize this moment, I notice this Monday night that God, if I build on for him, he will take my life to a level I never thought. How many of you believe that? If you believe that, come to the altar now and say, look now, I know this is the beginning of something new. Church, I'm not speaking. I'm not blowing hot air. I'm telling you. Look now. I know. This is. Jesus. A few months later, when that child was in her stomach and she was 6 months pregnant, I think she and her husband had numerous discussions. It all started with a moment that she observed. This is not just somebody ordinary passing by. Many people say, Pastor Andre, how can I get what you have? Many people say, how can I accomplish what you accomplish? You must seize the moment. And once you seize it, start to build on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I believe God's going to restore the honor of people tonight. God doesn't want you to end your life in humility. You know, you can be humble, but God does not want you to be humiliated. God wants you to end your life in honor. How many of you believe this is a moment you want to seize? There's so many people. Jesus, Jesus, give me the strength. Let's just wait on the Lord. Oh, Jesus. I'm standing in front of you because of a Sunday night in 1982 when I was in a similar church like this, and a word spoken over my life about America. That night when I went home, I said to my wife, I have just been in a moment that'll change my whole future. I was in another meeting on a Thursday morning, same church, when an older woman, a hairdresser, long pink nails, came out of Kentucky. A woman with the name of Jan Painter, wild, wild woman. She cannot preach. that she can prophesy. Pulled me out of the back of the church and she says, you will fly and fly and fly. And you will travel the world. When I walked out of that room and she prophesied things out of my childhood days, I said to my wife, I have just seen another moment that'll change my life. And here I am, 63 years old, and I'm still pregnant with more. Somebody say these simple words after me. Say, Jesus, I am here to seize the moment and do something about it. Say this as your personal prayer. Say, my life will not end with no honor. Say, what will come out of me will influence nations. Father, I thank you for every man and woman here tonight, and I thank you, Lord Jesus, that on the spirit of the moment, you brought me to the scripture reference. And I want to say to this church tonight, and I want to say to every individual, this is your moment. The old man still looked the same. Everything still looked the same. But something happened in his body. And he realized God backdated my season. Sarah was 90 years old. She qualified to die. God backdated her season and she became pregnant with God's plan. In a moment of the Holy Spirit, God can mess with your seasons. I want to say to some of the people here, you will not die when your mother died. You will not die when many family members died, because God is messing with the bloodline curses in your family. Church, that's the Jesus that I serve. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you tonight that they are on the threshold. Come on. Somebody say, I'm on the threshold. Say, I'm exposed to a prophetic atmosphere, and I take everything I can get out of this. Some of you are standing there in the back and you say, oh, I wish I could stand right in front, because maybe he's going to prophesy to somebody right in front. I don't think he will come down the aisle. Well, God gave somebody a word last night that sat on the balcony. You are not too far out. You are not close to me, but you are this close to the hot breath of God's word. And I want to say to you, if God can heal somebody here, he can heal somebody over there. If you can hear it, you can get it. Come on. Faith comes by hearing. If you can hear it, you can observe it. If you can hear it, you can get it. It's yours. Father, I thank you tonight. Then I can say to every man and woman here, there's a pregnancy coming to you. When Sarah became pregnant, Abraham realized she's pregnant, she's 90 years old. If God wants the child, then God will keep the mother alive. Because God needs a lively mother to give birth to a lively boy. So if you can carry the seed, then God will take care of you. Can I tell you what is one of the hidden truths about living longer? Carry something divine. Make sure you carry the seed of God in you. Make sure you are current. Make sure you're on the cutting edge. Make sure you observe when the God moments come. That will keep you alive longer than others. Come on. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you tonight that people is grabbing a hold of this word in Jesus' name. Come on. Father, I pray that you will open our eyes so that when the moment comes, we will not miss it. When the moment comes, Lord, we will not miss it, but we will embrace it in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. This man standing here, amen. Just you can go to another sound there. Just leave that for me. Father, lift your hand, sir. Is that your wife there? Father, I thank you. The days of being stressed out and being concerned is over. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you're going to make a way for them. And the hurdles that is in their way will fall, and they will have a smooth road ahead of them. I see you running the race, and I see you running over hurdles. And every now and then you hurt yourself and you kick another hurdle down and it breaks your momentum. Father, I command every hurdle to fall flat. And I pray, Lord Jesus, that sunlight will break through, sunrise will break, come over him, and God will give them a smooth ride. I come against the spirit of fear over you in the name of Jesus, and I break it. And I command freedom over you in Jesus' name. Come on, ma'am, I'll give you two counts. One, two. There you go. Power of God's all over you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Take it. Take it. There you go. Power of God. 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 In the name of Jesus. 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 Are you two together? Amen. What do you do for a living, sir? You work here? And she? What does she do? The devil has lately tried to come against you. Devil has lately come to come, and it's almost like the devil want to put a piece of dirt upon you. It's almost like he wants to depress you. It's almost like he wants to tear you apart. It's almost like he wants to tell you you're not even worthy standing next to that man. You're not even worthy. You feel you don't fit. You feel, and there's a tiredness that's coming over you. There's something in the body it's almost like the little signs in the body. You're concerned. I break this evil spirit that has come over you in the name of Jesus, and I set you free. And I say tonight to you, woman, you are so precious in the kingdom of God. We need you. And your husband has spoken to you, and your husband has tried to talk to you. It's like it's in by the in ear, out by the other ear. It's almost like you cannot lift this thing off you. Tonight, God is going to lift the heaviness off you, and he's going to set you free in Jesus. There you go, ma'am. This is the end of it. This is the end of it. The end. The end. This is the end. This is the end. This is the end. We're having good church over here. Come here, ma'am. Can I pray for you? Come here. Lift your hands. What's your name? Kelly. Do you have a husband? Where is he? Kelly, as you lift your hands, you say, Lord, that's exactly what I don't like to do because I feel like I'm so tired, Lord. You know, you would love to lift your hands for the Lord, but in the flesh, it's almost like your hands is not lifted up. You've got all those little, what you call it, cloths in your hand to throw over the people when they fall down, but you need prayer yourself. That's why I ask you to give it away, because God says it's your turn now. The devil has stolen from you guys, and there's a fire upon your house, and it's not the fire of the Holy Ghost. It's the fire of tormentation, tormenting. And it's a weariness and a tiredness, and it's an awareness that things does not work out. All the ends does not meet. Father, I bring hope to her tonight in the name of Jesus. I bring hope to her. And I want to say to you, Kelly, the Lord has not forgotten you. The Lord did not forget about your family. Life is tough. And when you throw a dime into the offering for the evangelist, you say, Lord, I wish somebody will throw a dime into my pocket. Lord, I pray, take care of her tonight. Lord, I break this thing over her. There's a tiredness over you. There's a weariness over you. it's almost like the road has become too long and the challenge has become so intense. Oh God, come on, church. It's so awesome when God touches one soul. There's so many here tonight. In the name of Jesus, 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 in the name of Jesus. Leba la manto la mereka la manto la mekete la meno la bakete la manta ya la manto ya. Leba rabara babanto la monte la mente la meke ne la bako shula bre la monte. Blessed ke la monte la mento la mana la basike la. God says it's time for an update there, sir. You are together, but the Lord says, I want to do something fresh in your life. You're sometimes the quiet one and you're watching things on a distance, but the Lord says you have a good heart before the Lord. And the Lord has blessed the two of you tremendously, and He's going to bless you even more. But God says, son, I'm going to bring you out of a hiding place, and I'm going to reveal more that is in you. Many people doesn't know who you are, and many people doesn't know what you carry. Many times you are like a dark horse for most people. They don't know about you. But God says, I know about you. And God says, don't run yourself down, or don't criticize yourself, and don't think you're not worthy enough. You are worthy. You know why you are worthy? My blood has made you worthy. You're not worthy based on your own deeds, but you are worthy based on what I've done for you. And Father, I thank you that you're going to wake him up you're going to wake him up. Come on. You have been dormant too long. Come on. You have been quiet for too long. Your wife has prayed for you. Your wife wondered about you. Your wife has spoken to you. Your wife has told you a few things. Come on, honey. You need to come. Come on, honey. It's good, man. Just come with us. And every now and then, sometimes you say, well, honey, you go. That's now her. You go. I'm okay. I'm okay. But she wants you so desperately. It's almost like she's saying to you, don't you see what's coming? Don't you see who's passing by? And the Lord says, it's about time that you say to her, yes, I can see what's passing by. God has not forgotten about us. God says, I will reward you. Come on. And Father, I thank you that he will see more of God's glory than ever before. Because the Lord says, I want to show you more of my glory so that you can also rejoice with the other people and say, I know what you're talking about now, because I've always also seen the glory of the Lord. You say, well, Pastor Andre, I'm not somebody that everybody just prophesies to, and I'm just not somebody that they will call out easily because I'm just not one of those. Well, you are one of those now. In the name of Jesus, I speak it over him, and I thank you, Lord, revive him. And let him capture the moment with his wife and say, I will not miss this moment on a Monday night. I will build on, and God's going to bless our household, and things will come forth that we never expected in a million years will come to you, specifically to you, in Jesus' name. Amen. I will come back to you just now. I hope I can prophesy to all of you, but not sure how that's going to happen. If you want to take a seat, you can take a seat. Otherwise, I will have to come down and find a few people that I need to talk to. For. But just find a seat for a moment. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. This lady here, can I pray for you quickly? Who are you? Is your husband here? He's watching me? Father, I pray that you will strengthen her in her body tonight, and that she will walk out of this place refreshed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. There you go, man. The power of God is all over you. I want to pray for two or three people that has a major problem in the lower back. If you are a lower back, you have a major problem. Come quickly. There's somebody that has major inflation, inflammation in the lower back. Who is that? You have major inflammation in the lower back. Is that you, ma'am? Come. Just stand in one line. If you haven't come yet, don't come, but come quickly. You have inflammation there? Oh, you were the one that I prophesied last night? You had a good night? You will have a good night. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you will, come on, lady, let the anointing just come over you right now in Jesus' name. Lower back problem? What's wrong here? Heart. Okay. How old are you? 15. You cannot have it. You have a lower back problem? God delivered this young man from dogs. He was so head over heels in love with dogs, but then God gave him this little jewel. And now the dog is outside the house and she's inside the house. Thank God you got your priorities right, brother. Amen. He's a good man. He has the most southern West Virginian drawl I've ever heard. He talks different. Father, I thank you that you're going to heal his wife. What's wrong with your back? Car wreck. When did you have the car wreck? 3 years. Lift your hands. Lord, I bring her under the anointing and I pray, let the back adjust and let healing come to her. In Jesus' name, I give you praise. I give you praise. Lord, I pray for this young lady here. I pray that you will touch her back. And this lady here, Lord, I pray, touch her back. And this man here, Lord Jesus, I touch the back. Touch this back, Lord. Touch him, Lord Jesus. Come on, lady, in the name of Jesus. Wow. Thank you, Lord. Touch the back. I give you three counts. 1, 2, 3. Touch the back, Lord. There's sadness in your life. There's brokenness in your life. There's devastation in your life. You are running away. You don't know where to run to. If you run to the west, the north, the south, the east, the west, you say, Lord, where can I run to? Sometimes you wish the night will come and you can fall asleep and drink something so that you can sleep deep and never wake up again. Oh, every day is another frustration. Every day is painful. You've come to the point that you say, I hate life. Life is not easy. Life is not joyful. Life is hurting me. Heal her body and heal her soul. Touch this lady, Lord, I pray, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, touch her body tonight. The Lord says, I'm going to fill you with visions and dreams. God says, you're going to dream dreams. You are already dreaming dreams. God is sharing things with you. Some people think you're weird. God says, there will come a time that the dreams will start to make sense. God says, yes, you're a dreamer. God says, you can just fall asleep and all of a sudden you find yourself in a cloud and you just see the glory of the Lord and people don't even believe it. It's all God. Bless the Lord, I pray, in Jesus' name. Is that the truth? Yeah. Yeah. Touch your body, Lord, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. If I've prayed for you once, you can be seated. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Come on, let's worship the Lord. Let's worship the Lord. Let's worship the Lord. Let's worship. Who are you, sir? I've seen you before. You are? Are you like him? He's an angel. Yeah. And who's that girl sitting there? Your wife? You sure? Come on, let's just worship the Lord. Let's just worship the Lord. Listen, are you two together? God's going to bless you tremendously. Hand of the Lord is upon you. There was a time that you were far off, but you are coming closer because you've got a fresh desire for the fire of God in your life. Lord says, you have strong leadership abilities, sir. Strong leadership abilities. But there's one or two things that did not go through some of your ideas, plans that God has given you, things that did not work out because there's sometimes a jealousy against you. There's a jealousy. There's people that say, where does he get these ideas from? Who is this man? They are threatened by you. You know why? Because of the kiss of God upon you. They hated Joseph. They threw Joseph in the pit because they hated him. Sometimes the gifting of God in us makes us to be hated by others. God says, you've come a long way. sometimes it was difficult. Your wife has been hurt deeply by what has happened to you and what was said. Father, I draw a blood circle around them, the blood of Jesus. And I pray, Lord Jesus, that those that have stolen from him and those that has taken from this man, you will no longer be in control. God says, I'm going to take the control buttons out of their hands and I will leave them empty-handed because I am your defense. Father, I speak a word of life over him and his wife in the name of the Father and the Son. Is this your son? Amen. You know about that? Huh? You've got a gentle heart, sir. Are you married? Come here. How old are you? 24. You need a girlfriend? Do you have a girlfriend? Do you know how to find one? This is a good man. This is a giant with a small little heart. You're a good young man, amen. What do you do for a living? Hopefully you're going to play basketball in Canada. That's not a job. Yeah. The hand of the Lord is upon you as well. You've got a gentle heart. Father, I thank you for a great young man standing in front of me. You're only taller because you're standing higher. Don't think you're taller than me. I'm just teasing. Father, I thank you for your hand upon this young man. I thank you that you're going to use him for your glory. I thank you, Lord, for a young man that is strong, that has a strong foundation, that knows what he wants. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that he will not be a pushover, but that he will wait his season and wait his time. And that he will make good decisions in life and not be influenced by weird people around him. Father, I thank you for your hand upon him. I thank you that you're going to use him in circles. You're going to use him in circles where you cannot use everybody. And you're going to give him favor like a Joseph in circles where only Joseph has favor. I thank you for that in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Lord, again, Jesus, that everything the devil has stolen from that couple will come back to them. Especially that many times when you come home, you are devastated because you saw another day where it's almost like they take your marbles away from you. It's almost like you put it on the table and then somebody else comes and take it. And you say, Lord, must I always be quiet and not say anything? Father, I take control over that spirit of manipulation and I break it in Jesus' name. Bless you, sir. You're a good young man. Amen. Amen. Come on. You love this? Isn't it good? Come here, ma'am. What's your name? Trisha. You belong to Maranatha? You do? Why did you take so long to say, I do? It's almost like you doubt for a moment. You were thinking? If you belong, you belong. Father, I thank you for this lady and I thank you for your hand upon her. And when you look at all the people, you just wonder, wow, it's a sea of people. Well, God noticed me. He did. He cares for you. He did not forget about you. You've come through a big fight. You've been left alone. You could not stay up with a crowd. It's almost like I see a big crowd walking, and you fell behind. And the longer you walk, the more the crowd that you walk with is leaving you because you could not keep up the pace. The world has taken away from you. The devil has taken away from you. And you are weary and you are tired. And the Lord says, I'm not in the crowd. I'm with you. I did not leave you. I did not forsake you. I will strengthen you. You've just come to a point where you don't just trust everybody anymore. You just don't know. You know, people say nice things, but it doesn't help a lot. You say, Lord, I need something from you. Jesus, I need to know whether you even still know about me. The Lord says, I know about you. And God says, I know what happened to you, and I know what was done to you. You cannot change it. You lost your joy. Your life is a life of tears and questions and brokenness. But tonight, the Lord is going to touch you, and God's going to, it's almost like God's going to give you a shot. Not only a shot of the Holy Ghost, He's going to give you a shot of vitamins. He's going to give you strength. Yeah. A word from God is like vitamins. One word from God is like vitamins. When you hear it, it changes your spirit. It changes your thinking. People say, well, I don't believe in the prophetic. What a fool. Father, I thank you that you love her and that I can just be the vessel that say to her, God is not forgetting you, and God is going to make a way, and God will provide. He will provide. Oh, yeah, God, will you provide? He will. Bless the Lord, I pray in Jesus' name. I pray that you will bring peace to her now so that she will sit here in peace and know that the presence of God is all over her. There you go, ma'am. Power of God's on you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Are you not the guy that has a gym or something? I need a coach. Yeah, I want to pray for you, ma'am. I want to pray for you. What's your name?
Billy.
Billy. You belong to this church, Billy?
Years ago. I've been back for a while and I haven't landed.
Now, where do you belong now? Oh, my goodness. Billy. You've been running. You've tried a lot of things, and you've listened to people too much. Christians. And they have influenced you. One Christian send you that direction, the other one send you that direction, and the other one has sent you this direction. Stop listening to them, because they've all been wrong. Listen to me. I'm going to bring you back to the place where you've started, and I'm going to make a lot of sense this time. You've seen a few things go wrong. You've taken the advice of people. You've run after, you followed the advice of people because you seek the advice of people too strong. You know, sometimes if you want to force a word out of somebody, they will give you a word. You know, sometimes we force Christians to say something that God never said. God says, it's time to start all over again. I have not forgotten you. God says, and don't even look at the past and say, well, I made a few mistakes. You've just come to the end of another circle. You've just come to the end of another journey. You've just come to the end of another big run, and you're out of breath. You're tired. You're weary. You just wonder, where is God in the whole place? You were sitting there. You have questions. You were concerned. And when I saw you over there, you knew I was looking at you, and you knew I was coming your way, because God is after you, and it's not over yet. Father, I thank you tonight that you're going to touch her, strengthen her, and help her to make the right decisions and forget about what people said, because some people already discussed you, and some people already made up their minds about you, and some people even said things about you, and you've heard it. And they're all Christians, and the Lord says, shut your ears from whatever they've said. You and I, we're going to make a new decision and a new start, and it's going to be all good. And the Lord says, I will work in your family. Yeah, because I need to do a work in the family, because it's like a lot of wild horses. They are not in the race. Everybody runs their own race. They have their own ideas. And you cannot talk to one of them because they will talk to you. But God says, I'm going to answer your prayer. And I'm going to bring all those wild horses in your family. Okay, shh. The Lord says, I know how to break wild horses in. And when they run all over the land, nobody can catch them because they have no saddles. A wild horse that does not have a saddle does not belong to an owner. Because God says the first thing the owner does is he put a saddle on the horse. And God says they all need saddles. They need to belong. And they don't want to belong because they know better than anybody else. In the meantime, they all know nothing. I speak a word of coming back over all these people in your family. And there's more than one guy involved. I thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Now you can shout. You shouted at the wrong place, you know. Yeah. Isn't it good? Wow, the Lord is good. Can I pray for you, ma'am? Hey, brothers, can I get a breath? Sorry, guys, you still standing up there? If you want to be in the praise team, you must. That's what you need to do. What's your name? Your personality in your life is like your hair. One day it's this color, next day it's another color. If it doesn't look good, you just try something else. Yeah, you've tried everything. If somebody wants you to be green, you'll be green for him. Somebody wants you to be purple, you will be purple for him. God says, it's about time that you take on my color. God says, you have pleased people too many, and not one of them pleased you. God says, I love you. I love your heart. I care for you. And God says, you've come through it as well. Man, you know what it looks like to look the devil in the eye. And then the devil look at you through the eyes of a man. And through the eyes of people. Father, I pray tonight that you will let her realize God can clean up all the mess. And God can start a beautiful story again. Yeah, that's what he does. He takes us all and he gives us a new story. Father, I bless her in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And I pray, Lord Jesus, in the areas where you have responsibilities now. You've got a lot of responsibilities, and some of it is because of bad decisions in the past. And you're the first one that will admit, man, I did not always listen to the Lord that well. But I'm willing to walk it out. And God says, I'm willing to walk with you. Because yesterday is yesterday. God says today is a new day. Father, I thank you. You're going to use her and you're going to make things work for her. You're going to bring restoration. And even people that were influenced by you and because of your bad decisions, they are kind of out of control. God says, I'll bring them under control. Who's that? Oh, it's time to pray for pastor's daughter. It's 9 o'clock. I just thought, Lord, she just got a call. Well, Haley Stevens, let's pray for Haley Stevens. It's 9 o'clock. Father, we pray for Haley right now in Arizona. We just got the call, Lord. It's 9 o'clock. And we thank you, Lord, that you're going to heal Haley Stevens. Amen. in Jesus' name. Everybody say, Haley Stevens. Come on. Send the name Haley Stevens. Send a text message to heaven. Come on. Just text message Jesus and say, Haley Stevens, heal her, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. God says, I'm going to use you to win over strange people. God says, the weirdos and the comics in life and those that have more tattoos on their bodies than what they have body left, those are the ones that you will use. God will ask you. God says, you're going to talk their language. God says, you are one of those, you will shout in the middle of the highway. And you do? You are crazy. You are one crazy, weird, strange woman. But God loves you. Because you are a Jesus freak. Give them all, Lord. You are a Jesus freak. You love this Jesus freak? I'm just telling her who she is. Come on, give God praise for a Jesus freak here in West Virginia. Fire of God, Lord. Come on, you're a warrior, man. Wow. Why do you laugh like that, sir? That's good. Yeah. Who are you? Jamie. Jeremy. Not Jeremiah. Jeremy. Are you married? Where's your wife? She's home. What do you do here? You're a catcher? What are you here for? You're a catcher? So if he's the catcher, who are you? You just love to be here. You just like it to see what God's doing. Amen. You're a character. Yourself. You're different. And you're not going to change because the Lord has made you an individual with your own DNA, own character. And I'm going to use you just the way you are. God says, you're a great ambassador for my kingdom. God says, you're not a fool either, but you're not going to be quiet, and you love the things of God. And the Lord says, your eyes has opened up to the things of God like never before. And it's almost like the last few months, it's almost like God is drawing you closer to the fire. You haven't been that close for a long time, but now you've tasted something, the glory of the Lord, and you're coming closer. And you say, Lord, I cannot get enough of this. I'm addicted to this. God says it happened in the last few months with you, and it's not over. And Father, I thank you for your son, and I thank you that you're going to use him for your glory. The power of God is on you right now. The kiss of Jesus just came upon you right now. The mantle of Jesus is upon you. I give you over into the hands of the Lord now. I'm just here to say to you what's happening. Father, bless this man, I pray. God says, I will give you favor. God says, you're gonna influence people, and you're going to influence younger people. You're going to influence teens. God says, you will go on trips, and you'll say, God, I will sell out everything for you. Because I want to go, Lord, on a mission. Lord, I want to be part where the heart of Jesus will be revealed to the people in great need. Father, I thank you. There's a mission's heart upon you. There's a mission's call upon you. And I thank you that you're going to use him greatly, Lord. And that he will go and his hands will be full of dirt. But God says, that's what you want to do. Father, I thank you for your hand upon him in Jesus' name. They breed them tall here in West Virginia. You didn't expect this. Wow. Who's that? That's your wife. You love Jesus? God says it's now your turn. God says you've been in the back, in the distance for a long time. You love the Lord. You always waited for the last few drops to hit you. God says it's about time that you come to the front. It's about time that you come out of your position, out of your hiding place. The Lord says, my hand is upon you. And God says, you never thought you would get a word while you're getting one now. God says, these are stirring in your life for a long time and you never thought much of it. This is stirring in your life for a long time and you never made much of it. You just thought, I'm just sensitive for the presence of God. God says, it's more than just being sensitive. The Lord says, my hand is upon you. You say, well, I'm the least and I'm standing in the back of the line. God says, well, I'll just make the back of the line now the front of the line. God says, I'm going to answer the prayers of your mother. Because there was a time that you wanted to spin out of control, but the prayers brought you back. There was a time that you wanted to go wild, and the prayers calmed you down. And you said, okay, Lord, I cannot want to run away from the prayers of my mother. And Lord, I will bow my knees. And the Lord says, you will become what the Lord has showed your mother you will become. Because the Lord has given her a vision about you. Amen? Is that your mother there? Yeah. Because you were into a lot of stuff and you were wild and you were out of control and you try to threaten everybody, even your family. God says, you cannot threaten my prayers. And the Lord says, son, I've got you in my grip and my hand is now upon you and I'm going to use you. And the Lord says, you will say yes because I will not take a no from you. Yeah. Yeah. And the Lord says, I'm going to wake up your, is this your wife? She's kind of small. Do you have children? So you've got three children. You've been busy. Yeah. Well, Father, I thank you for this couple and I thank you for this young man that's sitting here in the back and I thank you that you're going to get his number and you're going to work his case. And the Lord says everything that the Lord has given your mother since you were born will come to pass. You will become the one that nobody expects anything to come out of. You will be the one that will spit it out and they will say, it is the Lord, because we never thought he can say what he just said. Father, I thank you for your hand upon him and his wife. Amen. She's the quiet one, but she talks behind the scenes. And she's like a little bottle with a lot of dynamite in her. She doesn't say it in public, but she says it when it's necessary to say it. And Father, I thank you for your hand upon her. But Lord, I thank you. This is his turn. What's your name? Stephen. Father, I pray that you will bless Stephen and that you will use him mightily, mightily for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Isn't this great? Brenda, you guys are still here? Yeah. Brenda and her husband prayed for years. Can I tell you why the Lord has brought me back to Maranatha? because of somebody's prayers, but hers definitely. There was a time that I never came here anymore because of reasons, and she was the one that inboxed me. She says, Pastor, I'm praying the day will come that you will come back to Maranatha. And it went on for about 2-3 years. Every now and then she would say, oh, Pastor Andre, you must come back. I said, Brenda, God will bring me back at the right time. Just keep on praying. And then one day I said to her, I spoke to your pastor, and I think it's going to happen. She knew it before any one of you knew it. So I just want to tell you, don't mess with Brenda and her husband. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You guys can go home, man. It's already 12 minutes after 9. You really want, if you want to go home, you can. You can leave now. Jesus, we love you. Just love him. Just love him. Just love him. You feel better now, ma'am? I prayed for you last night, not for you. I prayed for somebody that sat here. Oh, you. You almost look the same. Can I pray for you? Do you know that guy? Oh, is that your husband? I mean, everybody's showing me what kind of sign. Come here, brother. Why do you have a pen in your ear? You're doing business? You never know. I'm just teasing you, brother. This is your wife? Amen? Are you guys married? Legally? Don't worry, I'm not. That's not a prophetic word. There's nothing prophetic. Not everything I say is prophetic, okay? I'm just normal, okay? It's your turn. God's going to open you up. There's something in you that is bothering you. You're almost like an eagle that flies, but there's something wrong with the one wing. And it's like every time, God says, don't be concerned. I'm going to make a way. I'm going to bring back your joy. I'm going to open up things that's locked at the moment. I'm going to release things that's not released. I'm going to work things to prepare for a miracle. Do you have children? How long are you married? 3 months. No, I haven't said anything. I'm just asking questions. Everybody thinks I'm going to say something about children. That's not my decision. That's your decision. I've got nothing to do with that. But you guys have very expensive taste, especially you. Very expensive taste. Wow. I hope you make a lot of money. She's expensive. You probably knew it. But God's going to bless you. God's going to bless you tremendously. There's a spirit of excellence upon you. You're going to lead in excellence, and you're going to be young leaders in the body of Christ. And you will lead by example. Everything you touch will have the spirit of excellence upon it. And you are so serious about the things of God, and you're drinking in every moment that God, even here, God says, relax, it's going to be okay. There's one or two things that concern you. There's questions that you have, things that you want God to give you answers on. God that just needs to clarify things for you, He will. Don't worry about everything that's not in place yet. It'll come. It'll fall into place. God will make a way. And don't be concerned, because there's a little bit of a concern over you. Lord, I pray that you will take this burden off her, and that she will just relax, and that she will just know it's going to be okay. God's going to make a way. Bless this couple. Thank you for a spirit of excellence upon them. He's trying to pull you into things, and you kind of watch things. He wants to run ahead, and then you are following him, but he's a little bit fast. God says, you're going to come into the things of God just as he's in the things of God. And I'm going to use you just as much as I use him. Don't underestimate who God is in you. Don't underestimate who God is in you. Because you doubt. You say, well, I'm not so sure. I cannot do this and I cannot do that. I'm just who I am. God says, I'm going to bring you out of your little zone. I'm going to bring you out of your little zone, and you're going to spin out of your zone, and you're going to discover the real you in you. God is not finished with you. Bless this couple. Great couple, great leadership, spirit of excellence, blessing upon blessing upon blessing. Psalm 133, commanded blessings of God will rest upon you. Not just blessings, commanded blessings will rest upon you. Psalm 133, go read it. Bless you. Amen. Amen. Now you work in the thing. Just worship him. Amen. Ma'am, who are you? So you are Michelle. Ooh, the devil has tried to smother you. Devil has tried everything to crush you. Devil has tried to hurt you. Why? Because he's a dog. Is that the truth? Well, it's going to change. Father, I thank you. Sometimes you feel like a little bird and you cannot fly properly, and you just fly and then you fall into the trees, and you fly and then you fall into the flower garden. God says, tonight I'm going to touch you. Father, I come against the spirit of fear. I'm going to come against that spirit of fear, and I'm going to say to you, Satan, you had your best chance, and your best chance is now over. I plead the blood of Jesus. Come on, church. She needs this desperately. Church, it's almost 20 minutes after 9. We could have gone home. But you know what? In the back seat sits a woman. You're like that other girl on the other side. Father, I come against all the spirit of fear. I come against the spirit of intimidation. I come and I break your evil spirit, and I say, you have no reason to torment her any longer. No, you have no reason to torment her any longer. Lord, I pray that a release will come over her body, and that her body will adjust to the new freedom that she has in Jesus Christ. Wow, your body will adjust. Your body will adjust to the new freedom that you have in Jesus Christ. Something about your body. Come on, Lord, I pray, lift her up and break this bondage that's over her for a long time now. It's the one thing after the other. It's the one thing after the other. And Lord, she's too beautiful to be crushed by Satan. Lord, I pray, restore her beauty inside and outside. And let the name, come on, church. Jesus is delivering her. Woo! Marabantula Mendo. I want to try and shout like her. Father, bless her in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. What's her name again? Michelle. Thank you. You've got a good memory. Michelle. Michelle. Yeah. You want more? How much more? Yeah. So you say tonight he's passing by, and I don't want him to pass by. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You want it all, amen? Give it to her all, Lord Jesus. Huh? 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 Do you know her? Huh? You love her? Oh. That's a Holy Ghost siren that's going off. When the sirens go off, you better know God is in the house. How many of you heard about Jensen Franklin? Jensen Franklin said he was a little boy and he will sleep. And he says, but then there's a certain stage in the meeting when the sirens go off. He said, and when the sirens go off, he normally stood up on the pew, little boy, and he said, the show has just begun. And then he watches how some people run themselves crazy and they run against the wall and they fall down flat. He says, that's when the show is at its best. So I'm telling you, the siren just went off. That's a sign that the meeting has just begun. I told you. Okay. If you have a back pain, put your hand on your back. I want to pray for you. I know I already prayed for people tonight over there. But if you have a pain in your back, especially on the right hand side, Jesus, let it go. Even in the right shoulder, in the back shoulder, wherever it sits, Jesus, let it go. Now, in Jesus' name, Lord, if it's moving around to the side of the hip, let it go out of the side of the hip, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You will be amazed how many people have their hands on their bodies now when I prayed. You will be amazed because I saw it. Many. Amen. Bless them, I pray, in Jesus' name. You want to go home now? Listen, your brother, I'm not a machine. It's easy for you to say no. I'm talking to you. And you just think I need to go on like a machine, and you just throw gas in the machine and then he just goes on and on. I'm not a lawnmower. Father, we worship you. We glorify you. Come on, let's just enjoy another few moments and let us just see what the Holy Spirit wants to do. Is there somebody here that has a stomach like a ulcer over here in the stomach zone? You, ma'am. Father, I thank you that you're going to touch that stomach now and that I can work a miracle in the name of Jesus into her stomach, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, touch that woman's stomach. Go right into the center part of the stomach and just clean it up in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Glad to see you, sir. I ate in your house many, many years ago. Who is these people? Your friends? Where do you go to church? Father, I thank you for blessings upon their life. I thank you for the hand of the Lord upon their life. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for a hunger in them that cannot stop. God says, I know what you have done in private for the Lord. I know what you have done. I know the paperwork. I know about all your stuff. And the Lord says, I'm going to bless you and I'm going to reward you. You are silent, but you are not inactive. God says, I know what you've done when people did not even know. And the Lord says, I've watched it, I've seen it, and there will be great fruit and there will be a great reward that will come your way in this life. Not in heaven, in this life. God says, I will reward you in this life. And woman, the Lord says, there's questions and there's concerns in your life, and there's some people that you are very concerned about, and you have questions, and their future is hanging in the balance, and it's people that you really love. God says, I'll take care of that. God says, you raise them, I will complete them. God says, you raise them, I will protect them. God says, they can run, they will come back. The Lord says, they're about to make a U-turn and come back. And God says, if they will not make a U-turn willingly, they will run themselves, they will fall, they will run into a brick wall, and they will say, this is the Lord, and this is the answer of my mother's prayer. Father, I thank you. You've raised them, he'll protect them. You've raised them, he'll bring them back. You've raised them, they will fly like eagles. They were out of control for a season, no more. God has answered your prayers. It's not a matter of he will, he has. Now you can rest in peace and just watch the show. This is a word from God for you concerning people, as it could be your children or something. I'm not sure. I don't know everything. Close to you, in Jesus' name. Amen. And even you know about it. This is great. You have no idea what God just said. Oh. One word from God can change a whole landscape. God's word is like a bulldozer. When it comes in, it bulldozes the landscape. And you cannot change it. He is awesome. He is mighty. He is Jesus. There's a beautiful woman with the name of Rose. A beautiful woman with the name of Rose. That is not a rose at the moment. What's going on there? It's the siren woman. What's going on with them? Every now and then they have their own little conference there. I'm going to walk over to her and say, she's just disturbing my service, man. Listen here, mama. What's going on here? What's going on here? You can't help it. It helps you. It helps you when God did it for her. How does it help you? You've never seen her before, but it doesn't matter. I thought you know her forever. I know it's
wonderful.
Yeah. So she never saw you before? Don't you belong to this church? You do? And do you belong to this church? Well, I just want to introduce you to one another. You've never seen her before, you belong to the same church. Wow. This is strange. They've never seen one another and belong to the same church. Wow. It's a big place. She's not going to listen to me. This is the first woman that shot in my face like that ever in the middle of my service. And I even like it. You've got strange people in your church, brother. They will never get a membership in another church. She said, this is her tribe. If you like your tribe, give God praise. Wow, come on, give God praise. Give me a song. Do something wild. Amen. Come on, let's give God praise and let's do a good song here. Hey, buy my book, buy my CDs. I need money. Okay, thank you. Are you ready? I'm waiting on you.
I sing because you are good and I dance because you are good. Because you are good to me. And I sing because you are good and I dance.
Come on, tribe.
You are good and I shout.
Do what a tribe do.
You are good.
Judah.
You are good.
Holy reflectors too, and in
I don't think they're ready to go home, Brother Andrea. I've waited all my life to be in services like this. Brenda, just let me say from the bottom of my heart, thank you for never stopping praying. Thank you. Thank you. Come on, now. Come on. Had she stopped praying, your throat wouldn't have been touched tonight. If she had stopped praying, Stephen, you and your wife never received that word tonight. Roger, if she had stopped, I don't know what it's worth to you, but I know what it's worth to me. If she had stopped praying, I'd have never been intercepted by that man of God. If she had stopped praying, Tanya, if she, Steve, if she had, Kelly, I don't know what it's worth to you. I know what it's worth to me. And I'll say, I'll go after God. By God's grace, I'll not stop going after the things of God. I'll not stop going after the things of the Holy Spirit. I don't care who likes it, and I don't care who don't like it. I want more of God than I want anything else in my life. I want more of the Holy Ghost than my next breath. My granddaughter breathed in the Holy Ghost as he was praying over her mama because someone didn't stop praying.
Maybe it does. Maybe I don't know. Maybe it doesn't mean a whole lot to you, but I'll tell you, I've waited all my. It's more than a dream come true for me. Have Myra just uncontrollably can't even control her excitement over someone that she does. Hey, you don't know what that's the love of Jesus Christ on that woman right there. I know what that is, Myra. I know what it is. I know what it is, and you can't contain yourself of someone you don't even haven't even met because the love of Jesus Christ rests upon you, girl. That's what the scripture means. Rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I don't know, man. I'll tell you, I could just stay here the rest of my life. I'll be honest. I think there's some people here just stay here with me. I really do. That's my tribe. I'll tell you, Heather, where'd Heather go? There you are. You know what? You will never know how it blessed me to hear that cell phone go off and you said it's time to pray for Haley. You know, we may not look a whole lot alike. We may not dress alike and our hair may not, but you're my tribe, girl. You're part of my tribe. And I'll weep with you and I'll rejoice with you.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Oh, I tell you, I'm full right now. I'm full and I don't have a clue what to say. And I just really just don't care. I'm just in love with Jesus. And she's a Jesus freak, and I'll be one too. She can have green hair and purple hair, and I can have stuff in mine, and we're just Jesus freaks. Has tattoos everywhere, and I don't have one, but you know what? That's my sister right there. Praise God, I'm full. I believe there's a product table out there with a book and several CDs. Make sure you pick something up as you go home. Brother Andre, thank you for being here. You'll be here back here tomorrow night at 7. I make no promises what time we'll get out. I don't know. And I don't care. I want I want all that God has.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Everybody, see, a lot of people think it's over. Whoa. They're heading for the door. All right. Man, you never know. Woo.
Come on.
Oh, man. Look out, man. Take your neighbor by hand, if you will. If you don't want to hold their hand, then don't. And just tell your neighbor, you're part of my tribe. You're part of mine, girl. Oh, I know. I know there's some people here from other churches. Hey, it's his tribe. So don't think I'm trying to get you to say something that, you know, I don't play those games. I don't play games with people. By God's grace, I don't play games with
them.
He's my daddy. Oh, and I love him. And he loves me. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for tonight. We thank you for all that you've done, Father. Father, I thank you that you brought Pastor Terry and Miss Kathy back home safely, Lord. It is a great joy to see the man of God back at his post tonight. And Father, I pray that you just overshadow him with your presence and your blessing. Lord, I pray you be with Bill Horn, Lord, as he begins to walk through this life without his wife beside him right now, Lord, but he takes great comfort in knowing that she's with you. So, Lord, as visitation takes place from 6 to 8 tomorrow, Lord, at the funeral home, I pray you be with him as the funeral is here at 11 o'clock Wednesday morning, Father. I pray that you just touch Pastor Terry. I pray you'd anoint his voice and his, Father, I pray you'd anoint his spirit, Lord, to bring forth the message you want brought forth. Father, I pray that it'd be a Holy Ghost revival service in that funeral. So, Father, I just thank you for every man, woman, and child that gave their time tonight to come out just to see what the Holy Spirit was going to do. So, Father, I thank you that you have not disappointed, God. I thank you that, Father, it's impossible for you to disappoint when we're just after the things of God. So, Father, I pray that you would just be with them on their way home tonight. I pray you give them traveling mercies. I pray you would guide, guard, direct, and protect them. And I ask it in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Can you give God praise? Thank you for coming. We'll see you back here tomorrow night at 7 p.m.